Good morning, YouTube. So my friend Brad McRae owns Authentic Details here in Austin, Texas. 2 months ago, we were at Cars and Coffee, we were schmoozing, and he was pointing out some of the interesting flaws on paint protective films, PPFs, you should be aware of when you're getting one. And I told him, I'm like, you know, here's the funny thing is, I'm a total car guy, and I have no idea what I should be looking for when it comes to PPFs and wraps, frankly. How do you tell the difference between a good one and a bad one? Everyone just says, oh, my cousins, brothers, uncles, nephews, former roommate does an amazing job. You need to go use his company.
I am your father's brother's nephew's cousin's former roommate.
How is that objective? Like, let's find some interesting data, or let's see the facts.
What's that make us?
Absolutely nothing.
About what makes a good PPF install and what makes a bad one. So we're gonna go out to this place, Authentic Details. They're actually gonna do a new PPF on the front clip of the Ferrari. First of all, that means, yes, this is a sponsored video. They are hooking me up, so thank you, Authentic Details, I appreciate it. But second of all, that means they're gonna show you what you should expect and what would be a bad install.
Work it harder, make it better, do it faster, makes us stronger than ever. After our work is never.
This is Brad, and this is Brad's shop. It's called Authentic Details, and he's gonna tell you a bit about what the shop's all about.
So, hey, we focus on paint protection film, ceramic coatings, paint corrections, and window tint is the core of what we do. But I got a chance to look at Daniel's car, so I wanna take you guys through some things I saw, and then we'll redo it.
Yeah, so unfortunately, it turns out my baby's kinda ugly.
Precious bundle of goodness! Oh!
So some of it admittedly is, all right, I am not a pro. So when I installed the PPF on this, yes, I did it myself. Let's just say it wasn't great. But the previous owner did have an actual professional install done, and we're gonna take a look. And even that install wasn't really great. And then we have some other problems, like my paint's really thin. Anyway, yeah, we'll go through it. I'm gonna shed some tears. I'll be off camera crying softly to myself.
We noticed a couple things on the paint first. We like to look at the paint before we put the clear bra on just to see what kind of rust that we're looking at. So this right here is a simple paint gauge. You can pick these up on Amazon. They're pretty inexpensive. For cars like this though, we wanna make sure we get one that works on non-ferrous materials and ferrous materials. So a lot of aluminum on this car, yeah. So we should be able to measure the paint just fine. So let's go through and look at a couple panels and see where we're at.
All right, so this is the one that scares me because you can actually see where it's too thin.
Let's see what we got. So 13.8 mils. This is actually very thick paint.
What the hell? What
so
on the side?
This has probably been repainted at some point.
Oh boy.
13.1. So what you may be seeing here is actually just they missed a spot or something along those lines when they were spraying.
Did you put it right on it?
Yeah, 15, it's even thicker.
What the hell?
So you might have really thick clear coat right here is probably what we're seeing.
What the hell? All right, so maybe they'll buff out?
No, it won't.
Oh, won't?
It's under the paint. So this is your color coat and they just missed
a spot. It's a really thick clear coat, but not a thick.
Exactly.
Son of a bitch.
So this panel's been resprayed, which means if we wanted to polish on it, we probably could.
Okay.
So let's see where this one looks.
Yeah, dang.
14.8. So the typical range for a paint is gonna be between 3.5 on the very low side and up to 6. We typically see between 4 and 6 on new cars. So we're seeing almost three times the thickness in this area, which tells us that this car has been repainted.
Great, well, I was 100% certain the bumper had been repainted in the back. In fact, I knew the deck lid had been repainted because it got scratched when we were working at one time, but I had no idea about the front of the car. So, damn, that totally blows my mind.
You wanna keep going?
Well, yeah, I mean, right, data's good, even if it's bad data.
8.7,
okay.
So not as bad, but still thick.
Yeah.
So maybe this is resprayed at a different time.
I'd say maybe they resprayed the front clip and maybe not
possibly
the rear.
Let's check the side of this panel because sometimes we notice that the clear coat's typically thicker on the tops than it is on the sides. So let's see where we're at.
7.5.
Okay, so that's probably more in spec.
Huh.
So some of the forums we've read have said that these panels from the factory can get up to in the 8s.
Yeah.
So this could be a thicker spray. They've also come as low as 3.5. So
yeah,
I wouldn't be concerned that this panel's been repainted. It's pretty likely that it has not. And this is the one you know has been repainted.
For
so
let's look at what this
looks like. So 8.5. This is repainted.
So you think they did a good job on that then?
Yeah, no, this looks pretty good to me. There's a couple little spots that I see. little imperfections there. Mm. It just looks like a raised spot underneath.
I know how you tell. How you tell?
You just let the reflection flow right. It's right at the top of my finger here.
Yeah, I'm trying to move the light. Well, maybe you can see it, maybe you can't. I'm having a hard time seeing that with my eye.
I look at paint all day.
Right, right.
It's probably more than I should. 7.8, okay. Probably in factory spec here.
Oh boy, this is scary.
15. So you may have had just the
I think the maybe they went to the door. Yeah. And what about the top?
Is that, let's see what we got here. Eight. Let's go back here and see. Seven. So this is probably all in spec, but if you look at this as all one body piece.
Yeah.
So yep. That makes sense.
Yeah.
What may have happened is there may have been some damage to the front of the vehicle. And when you respray a car, a good shop will do it this way. You would blend into this panel,
yep.
Especially with reds. Reds are really hard to match. So they'll basically spray this color and then spray some color into the door. And then they'll spray clear over the whole thing. So that may be why those doors are thicker. It may not necessarily have meant that they were damaged. But
right.
They just have they paint on top.
Resprayed the front and then blended back.
Correct.
Damn.
So that's probably what we're seeing. Now let's check the hood real quick.
Okay.
See if that was repainted. It's pretty likely that it was. 10.1.
So it's not terrible.
Not terrible, but probably respray.
Son of a bitch.
So, news to you.
Son of a bitch. Definitely. Yeah, we know the bumper. So the really obvious one, I'll show you. I didn't notice this when I was buying the car, and I should have. Is right here. If you look, it's kind of, see that little squiggle? It's a drip. So clearly the paint pooled here and then dripped down. How I missed that when I was buying the car? I mean, you kind of get googly, like, you know, like, I'm buying a Ferrari. You don't look over the car as good as you can, but yeah. Such is life.
So a couple things that we noticed on Daniel's car when we saw it at Cars and Coffee were just some spots on his clear bra, which is the reason I came to you guys, because there's nobody out there telling everybody what good clear bra should be. So we thought, hey, let's take a shot and give you the viewers what the information is that will help you determine whether you should accept the clear bra from a good vendor or reject it and ask them to fix something. A couple things on your car, not to call your baby ugly again, but let's show you.
It's okay. It's okay. My baby's ugly.
So alignment is key. So a lot of shops will use patterns. There is nothing wrong with a pattern.
Yeah.
Right. Patterns are great. If you put them on well, that's fine. But whenever you don't see things that are aligned to the part that they're supposed to be aligned to, so if we look right here, yeah. I can tell you what happened. This didn't align, and they trimmed it to fit this line here. So that's why you see the dip come up
and
go up again. The edges are not aligned on both sides, and it's a little high. And it wraps in here, and it's high up on this one.
Tricky to get these in camera, but you can see right there. You can definitely see it right there. See, it's not right around it.
It's the same issue over here.
See that? Oh, there it goes. Yeah, you can see the line, how far it is from the actual reflector. Yeah.
Now, one challenge I see here, if I look at this, if you want to look even closer, that there's a pattern issue here as well. So I've got a line that's here at this edge, and I've got a line down here that's too high. Now, if I'm an installer, I've got a problem on my hands. It's too thin right here.
It needs more material, right?
So, correct. So what we would do is we would basically pre-cut a small section. We'd modify a pattern and pre-cut this to test fit it to make sure that the pattern is correct. And if it's not, we'll go into the software and adjust it so that it fits this,
this place properly. So you can actually go and tweak the pattern and say, oh, make it bigger here, make it, oh,
yeah,
wow.
Yeah, we tweak almost every pattern here at the shop.
Cool.
Because they never fit the way we want them to. So we're looking for opportunities to modify the patterns to make them fit nice and tight. We would go in and measure where the we could wrap up into this panel here, because there's a lot of room for this film to grab onto this paint.
Right.
And so we're gonna wrap in here just to give it a cleaner look. It's a really easy thing to do. It's not gonna create any risk for failure later down the line. So we'll go ahead and add a wrap up here so that we could wrap that all the way around the nose of your car.
Perfect.
Wrapping over edges is a very big opportunity to make a clean install look good.
Yes.
So right here, we don't have any wrapped edges, and right here, we don't have any wrapped edges. When we do your install, we're gonna wrap all these edges in. We want the clear bra to look as invisible as possible.
Right.
Now you're gonna see lines, and that's okay, but anywhere we can remove those lines, we're gonna take that opportunity to do that. Where it makes even more sense to wrap over is where you were showing me this rock chip here earlier.
Yeah.
If the film had just wrapped up to this line all the way around over here, this is obviously your highest impact zone for your vehicle. It's the front facing part of the car. We want that to wrap around wherever we can so that we protect the paint, which is the job of this film anyway.
So another thing is, so this is the 3M Scotchgard Plus or whatever, Pro something. And it's only a year and a half old tops. And you can see, so here's the uncovered paint. It's very glossy. And then you move down and you can see right there, the line, all of a sudden it just kind of gets muddled. So in only a year and a half, it's already kind of lost its gloss. Quite disappointed in that material, because it was very glossy at first, and now it's not. And granted, maybe that's because I installed it bad, but yeah, that's disappointing. Versus the bumper, which is I don't know what brand, but it's still very glossy compared to the stuff I put on. So what's that for?
This is to check the swirls on the paint.
Oh, so by having it at a really high angle, you can see swirls better?
Yeah, it'll light up any little lines or swirls or imperfections that will be in the paint. Like there's a bunch of horizontal lines here that are going across.
What? How the hell do you see that? God, you have a better eye.
Okay.
Yeah, that is definitely not showing up on camera, but that is, wow.
There's a bunch right
That's
here
the
too.
Level of perfection you're aiming for?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Holy we want shit. All of that gone. We want this to basically be like glass. That's what we're going
I can't
for.
Even... Dude. Wow, you guys have a way better eye than me.
Good afternoon, YouTube. So, it's been actually about 2 weeks. So the scoop is, so that is not my 430. That is my friend's 430. Long story. We'll talk about it in a different video. But when Brad and the guys went to go remove my PPF, the 3M PPF ripped off a large chunk of paint. They sent the car out to get repainted from this one shop. That shop said that they didn't want to do it, that they didn't want to touch the Ferrari for fear that they would have to end up repainting the entire car. So they sent it off to another place. And supposedly that place is working on the car and should have it painted soon. Of course, then once it's actually painted, the paint has to cure before they can actually put on a PPF. I've heard various different amounts from 15 days all the way to 90 days. I'm not sure which it is, so we'll find out from experts. But we're gonna go out to Authentic Details and they're gonna show us some more interesting ways that PPFs can be done wrong. So we're gonna show you what to look for and what to avoid.
What we wanted to do was force some common mistakes that we see to give you, the audience, the information that you have. So if you see something you don't like, you know whether it's something that is, I guess, repairable, and you can demand that the shop either fix it. And then our bigger objective is to help all the shops across Austin and hopefully other cities just put out higher quality work so that you guys get great PPF installs. First thing I want to show you is very common to get small pieces of dirt embedded into the film. These will look like or feel like little bumps.
All right, there you can see the dirt.
So it's pretty common to find this in installs. Now, let's be honest, this is a big piece of film with a sticky back on it. Occasionally you may find one of these in your install that one of us misses, we're human. If you see a large majority of these, you can certainly ask the installer, hey, can you do something about this? I know this is dirt behind the film, can you get it out for me? They should be able to tell you, yes, I can get it out. If they tell you no, that's a problem. These right here are known as stretch marks. This is where the film has been stretched beyond its capability and the adhesive underneath the film cracks. This is something that can't be repaired really. There are ways to make it look better, and a lot of times even we get them on our installs. We know we have a process to where we can basically smooth that out to where it doesn't really show up on the install. If they're bigger, we'll just replace this piece in this scenario. And then if we look back up here at the top, we see an edge of the film.
Yep.
It's misaligned with where it should be. So we should be right at the end of this radius if we have an edge on film. Now you're gonna have other installers that may choose to wrap this over and around, or just choose to run it right up against the edge of the line here. Those are both good installs. As long as you have a nice even line that follows the edge of the panel that you're putting this film on, you're good to go. Here's another example of a stretch mark. What that might look like. And then sometimes you'll find what are also known as just bubbles of water in the film or air bubbles in the film. So here's one right here.
Oh, there it is.
Now, if the bubble is silver, like this one is, that means there's air trapped behind there and that will not go away. If you look right here, I don't even know if that's going to show up on film. Here's a bubble of just a little bit of leftover water
those will dry out.
Oh, okay.
So if you see silver, that's bad. If you just see a darker spot, that's okay. Don't worry about it, it'll dry out. And then if you look a little lower down here, we see film is hanging over the edge of the actual line. Now this is bad. What'll end up happening here if this isn't repaired is you'll get dirt embedded up in the film and it'll actually make its way eventually up into the film and the whole thing will start lifting. And then if you look right here,
this is the tricky one.
This is the tricky. We tried to get this one earlier and it was having a little bit of a hard time showing up. And what this looks like is a little indented line that travels a specific distance down whatever panel it might be on. This is actually what's called a lift line. And usually, you know, when we get debris or dirt or something like that under the film, we lift it up to get the dirt out and lay it back down. Now there's a proper way and there's an improper way to do this. This way was forced improperly so that you guys could see what it looks like. What's happening is the adhesive itself is changing directions, and that change in direction is causing a line in the film itself. So that looks really bad, especially on dark cars, because it'll be a little indented line in the film, and then sometimes you'll even have a little bit of a silver line. If you see a lot of deep scratches in the PPF, some shops will use a squeegee that's just got too hard of a compound, and it'll actually scratch the film up beyond its ability to heal. So we want to make sure that, you know, you don't have any scratches that aren't healable. If you see some, just say, hey, can you heal those out?
Yeah, those right here, right?
And they'll basically heat it up and we'll see if we can get them to come out. This is actually after I heated it, what was left.
There it is. There we go. Now I got it. Yeah, you can see the scratch. So that's the scratch in the PPF, not in the paint.
Correct. And it's beyond the top coat that's actually in the film itself. So it's not repairing itself. And I want to show you a couple of details that we do here, and also some examples of what you would want to see on some of the installs. This is a good example of what alignment should look like. I don't know if that's even going to show up on the film, but you have a line that runs right at the edge here. It's consistent. It runs exactly the same all the way down. That's what you want to see. Same thing up here, right along here. We took the handles off, so there's no seams here. Took the mirrors off. Typically, you would have a seam right up here on a mirror if you had a door. That doesn't mean it's a bad install. You just want to see those seams super tight and close together to where it just looks like a line. If they're spread out and there's a big gap there, that's not necessarily as high quality as you would expect for the price that you're paying for these installs. We did a lot on this car. We wrapped edges, we wrapped corners. You know, everywhere we could find a way to hide the film, we do that. So we pull a lot of parts off, like even you and I
talked about
the back bumper. We pulled the badges off, pulled the antenna hole off, anywhere we could find a way, pulled the antenna out to get this quarter piece on so there's no hole around the antenna hole. All that's gonna mean for you as a customer is that you're gonna pay more, right? Because it's more work for an installer like myself to actually do. Ask your installer, you know, what kind of installs that they do. And my biggest advice to you is don't buy just based on price. And obviously now you've got some ammunition whenever you're getting your installs back on things to look for and what to push back on. And I've heard a lot of different excuses, so just make sure that you hold your installer accountable.
What sort of like price differential, not maybe in dollars, but like percentage, would you expect between like one that's got some lines and, you know, maybe they didn't pull off the trim versus one that's got like everything perfect?
Some of the lowest grade installers, the ones that are making the mistakes and letting the cars go out versus, you know, top line install where you're removing parts, probably about a 40% price difference.
Wow.
Installers that are doing great work, but maybe aren't pulling parts off, you're probably going to see about a 20% cost difference.
Okay.
And you can always ask, hey, you're more expensive and compared to some of the shops that I've seen, why is that?
Right.
And let them explain to you. And they'll usually tell you, oh, it's because we do X, Y, and Z. Or, you know, it's because we don't do X, Y, or Z.
Well, hopefully you guys learned a little bit. I know I learned a lot, so I had no idea really what I should be looking for on what is a good PPF or a bad PPF. How those mistakes happen and how they can resolve them, or if that's a mistake that can be resolved, or if it's something that they just need to replace the entire piece. Thank you very much, Brad. And again, that's Authentic Details. These guys really know their stuff. And he wants to hook you guys up. So those of you that are in the Austin area and you want to get a PPF installed, Just mention this video and Brad will hook you up with 10% off any PPF service. So that could easily save you into the hundreds of dollars. Go get the hookup at Authentic Details. Their information is below, so feel free to call them, email them, go to their website, whatever you need to do, get in touch with them. Also, Brad was showing me they're expanding their facility to be this large, huge building right across the way from where they currently are. So they're gonna have two facilities right there doing all these installs. So they're obviously growing very fast, and you know, that speaks to their reputation, frankly. That's all I got for you guys. Hope you guys appreciate that. I know I like learning about these sorts of things, and I am not an expert on these sorts of things, so I'm glad that we could have an expert actually chime in and show you guys what to be looking for. You guys are always amazing, so thank you so much for watching. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions or concerns, and I'm sure Brad will watch this, and he could probably help answer some questions. In the meantime, subscribe, share, give me a thumbs up. We'll be doing lots of car stuff, so stay tuned. It's gonna be sweet.